guy. He's hilarious, man. I've seen him all around. And he was the winner of the funniest comic in New England. Everybody, please welcome Corey Rodrigues.
I was walking down by the slot machines a little while ago. If I see one more person with an oxygen tank, why are these people having so much trouble breathing down there? What the?
Songs about drinking and driving. Stop drinking and driving. This is for you right here, drunk drivers. If you are having drinks at the bar, don't drive your car. I don't care if the girl's in near wearing high heel shoes and has on no clothes. Yeah.
Listen, I'm gonna tell y'all about 40s real quick. You gotta be careful drinking 40. You can't just be mashing 40s to the head. 40, you gotta respect these. I'm gonna show y'all how to respect the 40. You understand?
I know you are a bear and not a girl. That's why you're my 40. Cause I can't stand to see you in the back. Let's see the glass on the 40. And when I'm drunk, I can't remember what I'm supposed to do. Cause of my 40. My friends know to leave me alone when I'm pouring out foam for home.
Watch this. This is my concession. Just when I thought I sell all I can sell, my chick on the sun. So she got food on the way. This is my concession. Man, I'm broke and I don't know what to do. And so I gotta sell all my food at the concession. If I gotta sell it, then I gotta sell it all. Popcorn, cheese doodle, and hot balls. I'm so broke, I don't know what to do but to sell all my food at the concession.
Damn, baby. Y'all got something messing with these snakers, for real. Messing with girls and stuff is a waste of time. I waste their time, they waste my time. I'd rather go pick up one of these snakers right here. Just to satisfy you, baby. Yeah, that's no pun intended. I'm serious. Grab your snakers, pop it open. Take a bite of this right here. I'd be like, God damn.
I got a bunny made of chocolate. Rectangular shape and a few little swirls. Peanuts with no peeling. Yeah, I know what I'm doing. A whole lot of chewing. I gotta get this over to my lips and do the bite thing. I'm in love with a Snicker.
You follow me, Brenda? I think he was, I ate some of what he had. He was digging in his ass and touching the food and everything. And I said, boy, you better get your hands out of the food. And then but he didn't touch. I don't know what happened with the food that he was eating. I think he was digging his ass and touching the food and everything. And the cotton cheese got mixed up in there. The guy that was there, somebody who made it in the back.
Round 8 and speak with the manager then.
Well, Brenda, if I'm having having an explosive shit, and I need to know who can help me with it, with the cotton cheese.
With the what?
Did you put cotton cheese on there?
Cotton cheese?
Yeah, because he was blowing his ass after the chocolate shake he had. That's what I'm trying to say. I don't know what I'm supposed to do, because he had the cotton cheese. You know, like when you get dry mouth.
I'm going to have our general manager.
Yeah. Okay. Who am I speaking to?
I'm sorry you're ill. I hope you feel better.
Who am I?
I'll have him give you a call in regards to this. All righty.
Who am I speaking to, sir?
My name is Ron.
Ron, okay, Ron. I'm going to tell you what it was, too. Ron, I'm sorry, Ron. There was one other thing we had, too, that so you know, just so you could run it by your general manager, okay? We had a cheese, one of us had the cheesy cheddar steak. And then the baby, she's not a baby, but she's just smaller, you know. She had a turtle sundae. She had one of the turtle sundaes. And I think it was the one who's not sick. Now, she's just fine. My wife, she's fine running around here and half her clothes is off. And I don't know if she's hot for me or from the food. But she had a portobello and Swiss. And she just only complaint she have is that her nipples is harder than they was before. That's it. But now, me, I'm sick. I'm sick as a dog, my friend.
Is the manager available? I don't want to give you a hard time because, you know, you guys have always given me the best food I've ever had, and I've been eating it, and my stomach's been swelling up, and I don't want to be gross with you, but my uterus has been getting bigger, and I'm sorry to say that to you, but I just need to talk to a manager to find out if this. I don't want to have to do anything with my health insurance, my HMO or PPOs. I don't want to do anything with it. I'd rather settle it out of court.
Okay, well, I'm the supervisor for the shift, so I don't understand.
What you would like to do. I just want to be honest with you. The sandwich tastes like I was eating sperm or something. I've eaten sperm twice. Well, that's too much information. I've probably eaten sperm four times in my life, and it tastes like there was vaginal babies in there. Do you make the turkey there, or did you slice it? I don't know how many slices I had. I probably had 8 or 10 slices of it, and it was all inside of one sandwich. I just said, can I have an American ham and cheese? And he put peppered turkey in there with spices of spermicide, and I don't like it. I'm sorry, Jane. I don't want any... I know it's, you know, 12 or 1, but I lost my dentures, and it makes me not talk the way I want to talk.
Well, who is it that gave you my number?
Oh, God. I spoke with somebody in the business office for accounting, the money. Rudy.
Well, nobody in there would have my number.
Somebody named Rudy gave me your number, and I'm very disappointed. Listen. If you could just tell me who else I need to talk to, and I could get it taken care of, because you know that if I he wouldn't have gave me your number if you weren't the one I talked to. Rudy gave me your number. He's a fat nurse. He's Mexican. And he gave me your number and told me to talk to you. Now, I need some answers because I'm hurt. My elbows are both broken. And I need somebody to help me.
Glad to have you here, man.
I'm glad to be here.
Oh, good, awesome. Doc, been meaning to ask you this. Any relations to a guy by the name of Cat Williams? The dog, you're the dog, he's the cat, and you're the dog.
It is 2012, niggas is all related. We're related if we don't know ourselves collectively, we know ourselves individually. We're all related.
Exactly. Look at You're here. You look like a single white woman. Yeah. Which is,
I know this nigga did not just say something about my hair. My hair is beautiful. It's shiny, whiny, and take a bitch out to diney. What it is what it is. It is 2013, and niggas is hating on people's hair. My hair's been hated on, but it's still beautiful. Say something if you love it. Love it. That's all the bitches say. They tell me they love it, and they put their hands through it and rub their fingers between it. It is 2015. Niggas is hating on orange juice. There's orange juice and there's tomatoes.
When can we eat our regular natural foods, nigga? I feel like I'm dying inside and I haven't had a good shit in 6 weeks. But that's all that happens. Holla if you hear me, shut an eye, shut a holla. I'm not saying it collectively, I'm saying it individually. If you tweet me, then I tweet you back. Shove it out here, shove it out, holla. Holla if you hear me, retweet.
I'm a Patriot fan, die hard. I'm a Pat fan, I love Tom Brady. I got a poster in my wall, in my room, with my wife.
See the difference with you, you're not a hater, you're a dick rider.
Excuse me? Well, no, I'm just saying I got a poster of him because I'm a Pats fan.
Any nigga who got a poster of another man on the wall is a dick rider. I'm a follower of Tim Tebow, but I would never, ever, in a thousand motherfucking years have that nigga on my wall.
Was that show they had, Grey's Anatomy? Oh, that show was originally called Black's Anatomy. But white people wouldn't watch it. Oh, they wouldn't watch it. They thought it was about a bunch of black bones. They wouldn't watch the show. You want to know about Black's Anatomy? Ask Lincoln. Lincoln knew about Black's Anatomy. Know your history.
NFL. Another race question, because I know this is what tickles your feather. A lot of black guys...
Oh, nothing tickles my feather. You use a feather to tickle. You don't tickle somebody's feather. Black people started tickling people with feathers first. Well, oh, everybody knows it. It's a fact. We were the first ones to tickle. You came in, all the feathers were black. Little crow feathers. That's what you usually tickle each other with. We get done picking cotton, we tickle each other with crow feathers. You were brought here against your will. No. Did you know that? That's one-on-one.
Yeah, I knew. I wasn't particularly made my ancestors.
Oh, nigga, you lost. If I went to the NAACP, I would find you in a bucket in a lost and found. That's where you are. Oh, that's where you are. That's where you are. You should be worn by somebody white. You should be an overcoat for Bush. That's what you should be. You know why they call it Snickers? Because that's what they used to do when they looked at us. When they look at our brown skin, they used to snicker. Oh, they are slick when they do it.
I don't believe that.
Yeah, well, it's true. Know your history.
And now our feature presentation.
Some stuff you can do out here, man. We just gotta find it, all right?
Like what? Tell me. I wanna find it now. Tell me.
Don't worry, man. We'll find all that.
I wanna know everything. What's gonna stop me out of here?
All right, man. No, listen. I will show you everything you need to know about Boston, all right? I'm gonna fix you up. We'll go get your hair cut, line you up a little bit.
Yeah, yeah.
A little part, and I'll show you a thing or two, all right?
Me
but this right here, this is not Boston. That's not Boston. Look at this. Look at this. Yeah, Boston.
This is Boston?
Yo, Corey, you know, what's up? Keisha from Philly, man.
Yeah, I know Keisha.
Man, I heard some things about her, man. I was over there turning up the house, man. I couldn't even get a good night's sleep, man.
All them damn kids, man. I'm over there one night. The babies and they crying all night. I couldn't wake up, man. The next morning, the baby's laying over the crib, guy even and shit like,
man, I am hurt.
You hurt?
Hurt.
Well, I seen you leave the club last night with that shorty. What happened, man?
Oh, man, we came back here, man. She scratched the meat out my
back. The meat?
She got a French manicure with black tips now.
That friction in there, man.
Yeah, you know that, man.
Bro, I told you it'd be popping here, man. That's every weekend, man. You come down whenever you want and it be popping.
Listen,
right?
I gotta come back to Boston again. This is real.
Alright, man, that's something. You gotta get it popping, man. Get it to the meat.
You special cause you got big buttons on your shit? That's some bitch shit. You need to get a zipper. You supposed to have all this money. You around here running things with them baby names on.
That's how you running.
I didn't even know they came in gold. That's kind of hot. Let me get your hat.
You got a hat.
I don't like my hat.
Come here, baby. Let me buy you a drink. Oh,
yo, my boy look like T-Pain lost mad weight, right? Come here, baby. Come here.
Really?
Watch where you going, nigga.
like Emmitt Smith. This motherfucker like Emmitt Smith. Look at him.
Okay.
He ain't nobody. He ain't nobody. Look at him. Yo, he don't even wear fitted hats. Yo, I buy fitted hats that don't even fit. Come on, who's this motherfucker here? Yeah. Get him. Get him. Get that motherfucker.
Money was a generator. Generate the attention of others, and you lose. Generate more money, and you win. Those with money understood this principle. Those without didn't. When Black started flashing his water cash, thought of something my mom had told me. A man who flashes his green doesn't know what to do with it. But this is capitalism. To stay in the black, major corporations needed guys like Black to be liberal with their finances.
Everybody collide with the colliders, but don't nobody want
my fucking money.
I don't have your money. What do you mean? I don't have any of your money.
I had $200 when I came home last night, and I woke up this morning and it was gone, and so weren't you.
You act like I'm the one who takes everything. I didn't take any money. I left because I went on a job interview this morning. Baby, huh? You shouldn't do me like this. When you start putting all this pressure on me, it's not good for a healthy relationship.
You have money.
It's not like that, girl. You don't have any proof. You don't have any proof that I took any money. I wouldn't do that to you. All right, you know that, baby? I don't do anything that bitches do. I'm not a bitch. You know, I don't touch purses, pocketbooks, nothing. You think I'd be a nice stealing your bras? Do you see me walking around stealing your bras, baby, huh? You don't see me walking around the house in high heels, right? If I put my pants down, but I have a thong on. I don't have any of your money. That's what I'm trying to tell you. I don't have your money. I love you, right? If I didn't love you, would I be able to satisfy you the way I do, huh?
Nothing wrong with the city, just some people been wrong there like everywhere else in New York City. I don't know why I love you, could be you remind me of myself.
Wall Street, I just saw her roll out of a tent. And she rolled out of a tent, and she's wearing these pumps. Are you kidding me?
Right?
Who comes out of a tent with pumps on? Doesn't that puncture?
It's like a closet in the tent. It's like a walk-in closet.
Unbelievable. Doesn't that puncture the bottom of the tent?
How you guys doing?
$500 for every minute of the video.
Okay. Hi.
How you doing?
Very good.
All right. My name is Corey.
Okay.
All right.
He's leaving. You leaving an interview for McDonald's?
He wants me to go with him.
Oh, okay.
The incantation. I don't know if that's the word. Incantation. Incantation. Okay. This is a poem of incantation. I ate from the hand of God in order to come forth to continue on this fractured earth. Impregnates my face. Oh no, sorry. She impregnates my face. Her hair taken, alternate liquid element. Insidious, she disowns a journey. Graphic signs, eyes, and a meticulous account, which no longer frightens them at all. Memory burrows from the flowers and forests such as art. Can I ask you a question? No one's in this right here. I don't want anybody to jump out and grab my butt or anything. No one's in this.
This is Ravens.
Oh, this is Ravens?
Yeah.
Okay.
He gets distracted easily.
No, I didn't want anyone to reach out and grab me while I was talking to you. It was for you. I noticed you. I'm sitting really close to you, and you smell great. I'm being serious. What's the secret? I mean, how are all these people showering? Or are a lot of them not showering?
A lot of them don't have a place to shower.
No, I agree with you. 100%
on that one. My sister lives in Brooklyn. I go every week, and I get a little bit of what people are calling around here Babylon, which is civilization.
Okay, so people around here are calling it Babylon, and so you get to shower like once a week?
Yes.
Okay. On every side, strokes appear, whence a voice approaching incantation. No, sorry. Whence a voice approaching incantation.
That's beautiful.
copy of a stranger in their childhood blue cuffs. And then it says in parentheses it has milk generations. Milk of generations. I don't know if I'm supposed to refer back to that in the poetry.
What does that line mean to you? Milk of generations.
To me, milk of generations, that just means that there's been cows around for a long time. And that's one of the holiest creatures on earth is a cow. That's why the milk of generations. Let's go to something different.
He's not your thing.
No, it is. I mean,
I know it's your thing, though.
What?
Freestyle Friday. Even though it's not Friday. Freestyle.
Oh, some freestyle Friday on Wall Street.
D's. You see me in Wall Street chilling with all the D's. You stopping to buy and don't get mad because the Wall Street we occupy. Stay and fly. Popping the collar, making you swallow. And I had the girls in the bedroom. Holla! Freestyle Tuesday, son.
Son.
Freestyle.
Right?
Let me get a little freestyle from you. Come on.
Freestyle. Just let it go. Don't think about it.
Let it go.
How do you think the weather is going to affect?
Oh, well, this coming week is going to be very warm. We survived the cold spell. I have a four-season tent. I have space blankets. I have two very toasty.
Like anything's gonna come of this?
I would like it to. I think that this is definitely going to be the thing that people are going to kind of look back and remember in history.
You might not laugh. We're gonna get another. Here we go. Don't laugh if you don't think it's funny.
Right. Yeah, don't laugh. All right, this little boy had the diarrhea. He was shitting all over the place. He was shitting everywhere. And he was like, man, I gotta go to the doctor. So he went to the doctor and he was like, doctor, I got to run. I need some Viagra. The doctor said, started laughing. But little boy, what the hell you want Viagra for? The little boy said, Viagra's gonna help me. He said, well, why you say that? He said, because my mom said, my dad always takes Viagra when he wants to make his shit hard.
Wah, wah.
Oh, really? Why am I being? Okay. All right. Okay. Let's try another one. All right.
Hey, you thought you were going to be an easy laugh.
No. All right, that's okay. Let's try something else. All right. So I'm a middle school teacher, right?
Okay.
And so, I just don't understand how, like, I'm a teacher, and I don't understand, like, fire drills. Like, why are we still having fire drills in schools? Like, why are we still doing fire drills? Like, at this point, we should have a don't get shot drill, right? Because people are running around the school with guns and shit. It's like, how you gonna have a fire drill? How many times are we gonna line up? And furthermore, I think the kid with the worst grades should be the last one to leave the classroom, right? There's a teacher shortage. Why should I have to leave the classroom last? You know what I mean? Like, I think the kid with the worst grades should have to leave the classroom last, like, put a fire under his ass. You know what I'm saying? Oh, is that better than the last one?
Well, it's a different form.
Okay.
If you're doing it that way, I think you're going to have more. Like, that you can take places.
Right.
Just having a joke. Joke that has an end.
So the real stuff is better, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, the real stuff is way better.
You're going to have a place to go from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thanks. I don't think we evolved from monkeys. I know you're looking at me like, you did, I didn't. I'm just saying.
That was pretty good. That was funny.
I just think if we evolved from monkeys, why haven't the rest of them evolved yet? What the fuck are they waiting for? Like, if you were a monkey and one of us walked by you with a coffee, wouldn't you be like, well, I could use a fucking coffee. Like, what?
All right, bro. Thank you, man. Appreciate it.
All right, so there was these three kids, right?
K-Fed.
I got him. I got him with that shit.
He didn't like the first one. He liked the second one. How'd it feel?
The first one was bullshit anyways. The first one was a street joke.
I know.
And then the second
one was a stolen joke.
The second one was Orlando Baxter joke. And the third one was one of mine that I didn't even complete, but I got him laughing, and then it threw me off. I was like, fuck it, I got him.
Got him, go.
Boom. Occupy that Wall Street.
Remind me of myself. Okay, I grab a Chardonnay.
Man, that's the second unthuggish thing you've done all day, man.
What was the first?
Not just say something about my hair. My hair is beautiful. It's shiny, whiny, and take a bitch out to diney. How dare you come to me and say some shit?
We were the first ones to be in the field.
But
oh, black people. Oh boy. Oh, black people was the one to tickle people first.